don't know, phone sex. I don't know how real you want it to be. It's like, yeah, like, do we do that? Like,
no, no, Matt, stop. Chloe's editing this. Yeah,
Chloe's an adult. She gets it.
Hey, health nuts. Welcome back to the channel. Today I have Mr. Matt here.
Yep.
My other half, the one who does all the grunt work behind the scenes.
A lot of grunt work. It's a lot. It's a lot.
We thought we would do, in the spirit of the month of love, Valentine's Day, all those lovely romantic things, we thought we would do a chit-chat video about basically how to have a healthy relationship. A lot of you guys will say like, hashtag relationship goals, and even like our friends will say like, oh, they like look up to our relationship for like what they want in their own. And you know, we're the first ones to say like, we are not perfect. I think I will agree. I feel like we do
have a
really
good relationship,
would you say?
It's a good relationship, but like anything, there's always room for improvement. There's always
areas
where you're like, I'm not doing too good in that, or you know, but being self-aware makes a big difference, I think, anyway. Mm-hmm. It's like, at least if you recognize or notice like shortcomings, you can improve.
That's,
you don't recognize
that's the issue,
then
is like when you don't do anything about it. Or, you know, Matt and I have been together for over 10 years now, crazy, a decade, and like, it hasn't come easy. We've put a lot of work into our relationship. I think that's why it is the way it is. So I had asked you guys on Instagram stories for some questions around relationships that you might have, and you guys gave me some really good ones. So, you know, we thought we would just like kind of answer your questions and I don't know.
Pretty informal.
Let's just chill on the couch, grab a snack, and hopefully
I could use a beer.
I have water.
That helps in a relationship sometimes too.
Alcohol. So you guys sent a lot of questions, and I'll try to like answer ones that a lot of you guys asked the same thing. First one here is that we got a few about is, hey Nikole, how do you, and Matt will say, how do you all keep a healthy relationship when working together?
Well, right now we don't, like, I'm not full-time in the business. Well, that's like, I work full-time in it on top of my other full-time thing, but because I get to go to, you know, sort of like leave the house and go to work, it's, we're not like 24/7 around each other,
mm-hmm.
You know, which I think it will eventually be like the route we go. I think because like one good thing is, you know, we each have our passion and our strengths, and I think we've kind of been pretty good at making sure that we work on like the things that the other person has a strength in.
Like, Matt knows I'm not the best with taxes, you know. We use programs like FreshBooks to make it easier. I will make sure to like collect all my receipts, put it in a pile for Matt, and then Matt's the one that's like, is the one that's gonna like get the nitty gritty of the taxes. Cause otherwise it's just not gonna get done, or it's not gonna get done properly. You know, like you wouldn't be the one recipe testing. Like, Matt hates cooking. You do, so, you know.
Yeah, I'm not gonna recipe test. And I think also, like probably you've seen before, like I'm sometimes not the best at like the social side of things either. So creativity wise, Nikole's kind of got that down. So we play to each other's strengths, which helps. You know,
in the past, I will say we've butt heads when we're trying to think of the right way to run the business. And, you know, Matt has certain communication styles that he likes with work. And I, like, it's just about learning about how you like to be communicated to. Or, you know, sometimes I would feel like Matt was saying that I wasn't doing enough, but it's because he prefers, which is something we learn. You prefer like more like hard,
yeah, just tell me how it
like,
is.
Yeah, but you blood. Like, what's it called? Like, you like tough love kind of thing. Like, you know, you could do, not like you could do better, but I like someone that's like, you're doing so great, you know, keep up the good work. And not like someone who's just like, you know, keep going, you know, it's just, yeah.
If you never met my mom, you'd know why.
This is true.
It's very, yeah.
So, yeah, I guess, like you said, kind of sticking to our strengths and...
So I think, if you are working at home with your partner, it's probably best to make sure that you guys kind of recognize, hopefully you're self-aware enough to know what your strengths are and allow each other to do that. And then, I mean, sometimes if you're going to disagree on something, like knowing what the other person's strength is can, you know, like you kind of like been to that person in a way, right? Like,
yeah, like trust that person.
I'll put an opinion in on social, and like sometimes it's a good idea, and other times it's like, no, it's not really, you know, like it's not really gonna work. And you know, I'm not gonna get upset about it. I'm just gonna be like, okay, like you know better on that. And same with like finance stuff, you know. Typically, like if I believe something to be the best way, even if Nikole disagrees, like it's just the way it'll be because
yeah, we'll kind of like talk about our put out a case, you know, like this is why I think this. I'll like talk it out, compromise. It doesn't have to be one way or the other. You can kind of come to a mutual agreement. So hopefully that answered the question. It's kind of a work in progress, and yeah, we've really communication is key. Like I feel like we've gotten so much better.
Yeah, yeah, getting better. Got to work on it.
Okay, so here's a little juicy one for you guys. How to keep intimacy alive in a long-term relationship?
I answered the last one first.
So, I mean, obviously, you know, when you've been dating for a while, you know, things like you start to do things less, like going to the movies, going maybe to, like, planning more exciting dates and stuff. That kind of like keep that spark alive. And I know for even Matt and I, we get so caught up with like work, and because like obviously, you know, the business and the shop is like our passion as well. So like when we are working on that too, it's exciting, but like we always need to make time for ourselves as a couple. So I'd say like keeping the spark alive, you know, definitely making time, whether it's like short trips, little weekend getaways, still doing those movie nights. Like I still really enjoy those, and I feel like when we don't do one for a long time, I kind of miss it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, having like sometimes we just do like romantic like wine, Netflix, and like order in, and we'll have just like a cozy time on the couch. I don't know if that's like.
I don't know. I think this area is like one where it's like we're good, but we definitely need to like be better at it for sure. In my mind and yours too. I know you voiced it before, because it's like because of like all the demands that we have on us. Sometimes it's like you just get so caught up in the weeds that you know like a month goes by and you're like, oh man, we haven't really like done anything. I mean, there's some great ideas out there that we like to try to implement more.
Secret date night.
Secret date night. One of our friends, Rick, and his husband, they do that, and it's
fun.
It's a cool idea.
Yeah. We have really a vlog cool. on that. I'll link it down below if you guys want to check it out.
And like we kind of did it a couple of times, and then once again, like life got in the way, we fell off the bandwagon. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes even like just now, like with winter, like sometimes when it's like minus 30, like we're just sometimes like the intimacy. Is just sitting inside on the couch and like, you know,
it's hard. It's something you have to work at. It's something you need to plan. We will schedule it into the calendar. Like even this morning, I told Matt like, oh, we should go for a walk today because it's not like minus 30 today. And you know, Matt put it in my calendar like a walk at 5. So you know, after we're done filming this, like we're gonna go outside for a walk and get some fresh air. And like I find just making time, whether you have to actually physically schedule it into your calendar or just talking about it. I'll notice sometimes we get in the bad habit of like maybe we don't like, you know, give each other a good morning kiss or something, like little things like that. Maybe you need to cuddle a little bit more on the couch, maybe you need to hold each other's hands while you're walking. Like those are things, like I know everyone has like different things that they look for in terms of like just keeping that kind of relationship alive. But like I like those little mushy gushy romantic things. So sometimes like Matt will, if I tell Matt, like, Matt, I really like when you give me a kiss in the morning, like, he'll make a conscious effort to do that. But, like, sometimes it's just something I need to tell you what I want more of.
Yeah, communication helps.
You know? Matt likes it when I clean, you know? So. Okay, so hopefully that answered that.
I do enjoy cleaning.
Who does? Okay, so there's a couple questions about jealousy. And here's a good one. Do you ever feel jealous about Matt hanging out with other female friends? He's not allowed to. So, what would you say? Do you feel like I get jealous?
No, I don't think so. I mean, I don't know. It's a tough one. I mean, jealousy, it can creep up, I think, up for anyone. I think, like...
They say jealousy is like the termites of a relationship. I just always think about that.
I mean, I think, for me, I always think, like, the best remedy to jealousy is, like, making sure that you are the best version of yourself that you can be, because I don't know,
like
I just
confident
always,
someone who's really confident is less likely to be jealous.
I just think like if I you know like try to take care of myself, try to eat well, I'm working hard, I'm you know, trying to be more successful. Like, if you're just trying to be the best person that you can be, then in the end, like, I'm not jealous, because if, you know, Nikole decided she'd rather be with someone else, that'd be the, you know, it's one of those things where it's like, okay, like, that's the decision that's made. You know, that's how a person feels. You can't really change it. And it's just like, okay, well, I know I'm the best version of myself. I'll find someone else too, right? So I think being confident enough to know that, like, we're not together because, like, we have to be. We're together because, like, we choose to be.
We've said that for a long time. It's not out of, we're not together out of a convenience or comfort. It's because we choose to be together. So that's a big thing. And I will say that when I first met you, Matt is someone that, just like, I feel like I get along with a lot of guys, you get along with a lot of women. And when I first met you, like, and you still have, like, a lot of female friends, but, like, when I first met you, you had a lot of female friends.
Yeah.
And so that was a bit different for me. I was like, oh, okay. But you know what? I kind of just, like, gave him, like, the benefit of the doubt. I want to meet these girls that he hung out with and stuff. And Matt has, like, the best character, like, sense of judgment of character. Like, everybody you've introduced me to that you've become friends with, like, when we met or when you were out in Alberta, like, the nicest people. So
good people.
Yeah. And so if I meet someone who happens to be a female that's friends with Matt, like, unless I just go off, like, my intuition. Like, if they're giving me a weird vibe that they're, like, trying to, you know, secretly hook up with Matt or something, well, like, I might not want to hang out with them. Or if someone was, like, rude to me, like, if they gave me jealousy vibes or rude to me or something and didn't want to hang out with me, but they want to hang out with you, like, that's a red flag too.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And you know what? I've been jealous in the past with other boyfriends, and it's just, like, it's no fun. So I feel like I've been the least jealous with you than I've ever been. And so I think it's so much better.
Yeah. So my advice to summarize would just be, for me, it's just be the best version of yourself. That way you know that you're a great catch, and, you know, there's really no need to be jealous, because, you know, you're doing everything you can to be, like, the best person.
And I'm gonna add communication. Matt was out doing something, and in the past, I think when we first started dating, there must have been a couple times where I was like, I kind of felt jealous, I didn't really like that, you know, I would just tell him, just talk about it, it's fine, it's not a whole game, you don't have to keep everything secretive, just talk it out, you know. So that's another thing too.
Yeah, it's good.
Okay, so we might as well talk about the elephant in the room that you guys always ask. Probably get asked a lot. That's part of the question. Yes, we do. Are you guys getting married / believe in marriage? So we've been together, this June will be 11 years, which is kind of crazy.
It's a long time. Long time. I mean, sure.
Hot seat.
No, it's not even a hot seat, really. It's like, so for me, whether we got married or not isn't really, it's not like a make or break. So just the way that, like, my mind works is, like, I don't feel like that I need that to feel fulfilled in a relationship. That being said, I mean, as we said before, like, compromise is a big thing. So, you know, marriage is more important to Nikole. It's, like, something that, you know, she would like to have. So, yeah, I mean, like, we will get married at some point. It's not, it's not like a, I don't know.
Well, I would say... I would say that a lot of relationships are kind of the opposite of ours. Like, people, you know, maybe, I don't want to say rush into, but they, like, get married, they have kids pretty soon after kind of meeting each other. And Matt and I, really, when we met, like, I was in college, we were planning to, like, move to Australia for a couple of years and travel the world. And we kind of did all that stuff earlier on. And I feel like because of the schooling and traveling and also just, like, building the Health Net business, that was, like, so much of a passion, that was taking up so much time, that, like, I wasn't thinking of marriage and kids and all that, you know. That was, like, the last thing on our list. I knew I wanted those things, and I still do, but they've just kind of been pushed back a bit. Like, we've done so much in a relationship earlier on that I always think that if, you know, Health Nut wasn't a thing, I would probably be way more, like, baby focused. Like, I want to have kids early on, but, you know, it's something that now, 10 years later, that we definitely talk about more. It's important to me. I'm not super religious either, even though I grew up in a Catholic family. I just, you know, I think it's, you know, nice to have kids and be married and have the same last name and all that. And so it's definitely something.
You're not even going to take my name if we get married. Maybe you don't want to be Varga. I don't think you do.
I don't know. I feel like you should take my last name.
Look at that, right?
Like, So.
But I think in the end, like, yes, it is something that we will go down that road. I mean, like I said, it's important to Nikole. It's not, like I said, it's never been like a thing where I'm like, oh no, I just never would do it. It's just been I don't need it in my life. You know, and like some people, it's an important thing, and other people, it's sort of not, right? But for me, I guess like push come to shove, you know, like, would I rather be with her and get married, or like be without her and like not get married? It's like, it's kind of a no-brainer to be like, yeah, it's kind of a no-brainer. It's just like, yeah, be with her. But like, to Nicole's point, you know, we've had a lot of fun in our life. We've, you know, I think built a good relationship, you know, and part of that was doing things our own way, not conforming to what sometimes society believes, you know, like you should do. It's just sort of just doing what feels right for you. And
like, I think it bugs other people way more than, like, we don't think about it all the time. Like, I'm thinking about more and more now, and like
thinking about
you know,
more.
When the good time is. But like, it's like everybody else is just like, why aren't you guys married? Why aren't you married? Which, like, I don't get offended when people ask, but at the same time, I know lots of people that are married and like,
They're not happy.
So marriage doesn't make a happy relationship. So if you're out there and you don't really want to get married, or you feel like you have to get married because the society or friends are telling you, like, it does not grow a stronger relationship. So I feel like we have one of the best relationships that I've encountered. I'm biased, but it's like, we're not married and we're very happy. So it's definitely, don't get married to improve your relationship. Have a good relationship first, and then choose to get married. Yeah. Hopefully that answers the question. We get asked a lot, and it's not that we're avoiding it. It's just like, it's a sensitive topic for Matt because he feels pressure. You must get like the pressure. You do.
Yeah, maybe.
Would be great to hear some advice on long distance. Love your videos. Thank you. Ooh. I feel like we've mastered this one. Not mastered, but we've gone through it a lot.
Not mastered. I mean, like, so in the 10 years that we have been together, I feel like at least, with like my travels, and I was living on the different side of the country for a couple of years, like out of the 10 years, it was like almost like 2 or 3 years, but we were like long distance
with
traveling and different things if you add it all up. So I mean, I think one thing is you know, technology is like fantastic too, right? I mean, like, nowadays, yeah, you can use like Skype, FaceTime, text, Facebook Messenger, you know. There's just so many different avenues to be able to actually like stay in touch and connect with your partner, you know, phone calls, like all those different things.
We used to have like wine and dinner night dates on Skype, where like we would actually eat. This is when Matt was in Alberta, so out west in Canada, and he would like be eating dinner or drinking some wine at the same time I was, and we just have like a little romantic night together. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I
wouldn't say romantic. It was
I thought it was romantic.
Yeah? Okay.
And
my leg.
You're cramping?
Oof. Cramp, guys, sorry.
And another thing that we would do all the time, because I want to give you guys some like tangible tips.
Yeah.
So like the Skype dinner dates were really good. Just making time for both of you guys, especially if you're on different time zones, that's really important. My favorite thing that we did was morning voice memos. My favorite thing. Every morning, nice. I would wake up before you did.
Yeah.
And I would drive to, this is when I was commuting to work, I would drive to the GO station, and I would basically just put my phone on the voice memo app and that it comes with, and just record. It started off with like a minute. We ended up doing like 10 minute voice memos, or I did.
Some long ones.
And we would just like talk about our day, and then when Matt would wake up, he would listen to mine, and then he would respond to it, and then I would listen to his later on. So it was really fun, because I never felt like, it was like, no matter what, we got a recap every day on what we're doing. I would highly recommend that. That was like one of my favorite things that we did.
Yeah, so voice notes, utilizing technology, you know, making the effort to stay connected.
You'd always say, like, you would get mad if I didn't say goodnight. You're always like, we should make a good habit of like saying goodnight before we go to bed.
Yeah, that's important, I think. So.
Yeah.
Anything there you else go. You'd say? I don't know, phone sex. I don't know how real you want it to be. It's like, yeah, like, do we do that? Like,
no, Matt, stop. Chloe's editing this.
Chloe's an adult. She gets it. She's not blind.
Okay, stop. Stop. Okay, oh my god, I'm gonna be so. I'm gonna be so red.
Yeah, I thought you wanted like real chat.
Oh my god, okay. Sexting.
Sexting is a thing too.
Might be a bit personal, But I'm always curious about how different couples deal with their finances. I agree. This is like, oh, I feel like everyone has their own strategy. It is kind of a personal thing, which I don't mind talking about it, but it is, people are very like guarded and secretive about finances.
Okay, so fire away. Let's hear what you have to say.
Okay, well, I would say I grew up with my parents kind of, if I'm going to be honest, like there was a lot of, you know, both of them had to have different spending habits. So there was a lot of like, I guess, butting heads in that aspect of the relationship. And, you know, over the years, I feel like they've kind of made it work. But like, I always knew that. So I kind of grew up thinking like, ooh, finances are very, it's like high stress, very secretive. And then when I met Matt, he was very open. He's like, yeah, I make this much. This is how much I have in my savings account. Like, you were so open, and he was the most open person I ever met with money. And he kind of got me used to not looking at money as this like negative thing, but it's like a positive thing. It's something that can help you travel, help you do what you want in life. And debt doesn't have to be necessarily always bad debt. You can still do things with debt. And I kind of grew up with being like, no, you gotta pay off your debt before you can like enjoy life. So I would say you kind of changed my perspective with money. And I always knew that I never wanted money to be something I would fight about with whoever I was with. So that was important to me.
Yeah, I mean, I think like an important thing is to know, like, I mean, I'm a forward thinker, always sort of been. So I mean, like, I think if you guys both need to know like what your long-term plan is. You need to have some sort of plan or vision or something that you're working towards. Otherwise, like, how can you
stay motivated to save money or?
Yeah, or just like, how can you both be on track, you know, in a mm-hmm. common goal if you don't have a common goal, right? Like, if we didn't have a future plan and we were both just throwing money away and not, you know, using our head, you know, maybe this things would be a bit different, right? But because we both are kind of like, hey, we know we're growing the business. Hey, we know we invest in real estate. Hey,
we have staff to pay. Like, we definitely have to.
Because we have like the same sort of vision and the understanding of like, sure, is there months or times where it's like, oh my God, we spent too much on this or too much on that. You know,
you're definitely more conservative.
I'm more of a conservative, liberal, like saver, thinker, planner. So there's definitely times where like, I'll be like, Nikole, you just spent like way too much money at Zara.
Never.
Close your shop.
I will say you have to like recognize there are things like Matt spends money on that like I don't spend money on.
Yeah.
And there's things that like even just being, you know, a woman, I spend things on like whether I go get my nails done, whether I go get, I don't know, a bikini wax, like whatever, like there may be things that I get that you don't get and you're like, oh, like I'm pretty sure you get your hair done more than me, but like there are things that as a woman, I'm gonna spend money on and you're not. So I think you have to be flexible and not control the other person's spending habits. But like, obviously if they're just really bad with money, you do need to talk about it. But communication is so key when it comes to finances because people can get very guarded about it. Like if you know, we both work hard, we both make good money. And like, if you were to like tell me how to spend my money, I'm gonna like put up a wall, right? It's about really kind of coming at it in a understanding, compromising way. And I think the planning and goal setting is so important because if you both know what you're planning to go towards, then you know like, maybe I'm not gonna go to Zara this month because I know we're looking to buy that cottage this summer or something like that. You have like a goal
trip
in mind. Yeah. So battery just cut out, so we don't know where we were exactly, but we're talking about finances.
Yeah, so I think to summarize, have a goal, a mutual goal that you're working towards, that you're both motivated by. It's really gonna help make a difference. And then I think just being open, honest, not being afraid of money. Like
not making it to be this like evil,
like an evil
negative thing. Having a good relationship with it. So last question here is, how do you solve arguments and disagreements? Do you have somewhere to go? You checking your steps?
Nope. It was just buzzing saying you haven't moved in an hour. So it's like, okay.
Okay, so how do we solve arguments?
I think just knowing that I'm right all the time.
Yeah, okay.
Makes a difference.
So I think the important thing is like we do fight. I will say that like we don't fight that often, but we like as we've gotten older and just, you know.
And we never like scream.
Oh, we should.
Yeah.
We don't, scream. Like, I will raise my, I'm just a loud talker. Like, just so when I get heated, Matt will be like, all right, squeaky voice. Like, I get into this high-pitched squeaky voice. Mm-hmm. And he kind of, like, makes me aware of it. But, like, we don't scream at each other. We don't slam doors. We don't break things. We don't call each other names. I've never called you a name. Not to your face.
Damn.
So we don't, because like at the end of the day, I don't want to say anything that I'm gonna regret later. Like, why would I say things like I love you? Why would I say things that are hurtful
and I'm very fond
spiteful
of her.
And shut up? No, so but, we respect each other, and that's really what it is. Like, I respect you enough to not act out of just like the heat of the moment. And I think you were talking about this before. Like, in the beginning, I used to be very hot tempered. Short to react, and Matt was always so level-headed, and now, like you're saying, like, things you feel like kind of
Now there's definitely times where I'll be a bit more like quick to react to something, and then you'll be more level-headed. So that's kind of like worked out well, where it's like at first I was more that way and kind of calmed things down, and now, you know, Nicole's definitely more, not like definitely more, but like,
but there's a lot more, there's a
big change in like her ability to kind of like
be, you know, rational, ease
the situation, and just be like, okay. So I mean, it's important to kind of have one person who can do that, and, you know, like Nicole said, like, we never scream at each other, we never, you know, throw things.
We've never like temporarily broken up.
I've never like thrown something at someone before. I don't even know. Like, sorry if you have or not, but I'm just like, in my mind, I'm like, why would I even throw something at someone ever? I don't get it. But yeah, it's good for someone to just disengage, step away, you know, say like, hey, like, this is, we're getting over here, like, let's take a break, yeah. You know, and like, sometimes all it takes is like walking away from a situation, going for some air, going to the gym, whatever you need to, to just like release a little bit of like steam, and then like, and then come back to it.
Yeah, and sometimes it's just being together a lot, you know, you can fight out of boredom even, and just being together a lot, you know, you're gonna have certain things that tick, like, that just irritate the other person. So sometimes we'll just be like, yeah, maybe we need to go like spend some time with other friends, or just like get out of the house and do something, you know. Yeah. Like, I do think that a lot of people fight out of just like being tired, stressed out, bored. So maybe look at what the root cause is. Are you guys arguing about the same thing all the time? Like, what is the root cause, instead of just like the surface level kind of arguments? So
yeah. And like, I think it's important too, is to like have time apart, or like have a hobby or friends or something that you do something with outside of, you know, like each other. Like, you know,
like, there's a world outside of your relationship.
There is, and it's good to like not forget that. Yeah. I think too. Right? Even like if it's just like, I'll be watching, you know, TV here, and Nicole be in the room watching like YouTube stuff, where I'm like, I have no interest in watching.
But she's like
watching
there, and like my tea and stuff.
Yeah,
and
she has no interest. Yeah, in watching maybe a shoot 'em up movie or something. So sometimes it's good to just be like, okay, well, I want to do this, you want to do that. Like, there's nothing wrong with us like doing something separately. You know, even if we're in the same house, right? It's like, okay, you know.
I agree.
Okay, hopefully that helped someone out there.
A lot of people were asking about, do we want babies?
I feel like we talked about, did we not talk about the marriage stuff?
Yeah,
babies.
I feel like we've talked about it before. So
three or four, probably. I think. Not all, I don't think like all like.
Matt wants a big family because I have a big family.
Yeah, your family's cool, man. We have like, yeah, you got four siblings. I got, you know, three. There's three of us. There's four of you guys. So.
We definitely want kids.
Yeah, I like a bigger family. Yeah. But I think likely we wouldn't have four naturally of our own. We'd probably have one or two, and then, you know, and then looked at like different options, like an adoption.
Adoption has always been something I've been
interested
in. We're
both open to that idea, you know, like, there's a lot of people out there who need a nice home, and, you know, I think we could provide one. So something that I think we would look at. Haven't gone down that road, haven't done any research. We know people who have.
But in terms of, we definitely, like, I know I would not feel fulfilled personally if I wasn't a mom at some point. I know Matt wants to be a dad, and I think he'd be like an amazing dad. And I think that, yeah, it's something that we talk about more and more. And I know personally, I wanted to wait later till I was a little bit older so we can be like more financially stable. Yeah. I didn't want to have kids super young and then have to worry about finances and that stress on top of it. And not that money solves everything by any means, but it just makes things a little bit easier, especially too, because, you know, we do run a full-time, you know, multiple full-time businesses. We do real estate investing on the side. And if we ever needed to invest in some help, whether house cleaning or babysitting or something like that, or daycare, I would want to be able to have the means to do it. So that was always like really important to me too.
Yeah.
Anything to add to that? 4 kids, apparently. Yay. You gonna have them? Yeah. And the other thing too is I also like wanted to make sure that whoever I was having kids with, I know would share the responsibilities equally. Like, you know, cause that's a big thing. A lot of times, like it's, I'm not gonna always say it's the female, but it's like one person is taking most of the responsibility and I just don't think that's fair. I really, you know, I know Matt will share half of the responsibilities. He'll be also getting up in the middle of the night, you know, given the milk, the bottle of milk or whatever, diapers change. Like there's nothing more unattractive than guys being like, I don't do diapers. So, you know. That's so annoying. I hate that.
Yeah. Anyways. I never change a diaper.
You will.
Yeah.
All right. So I think we, hopefully we answered a few of your questions. You guys had some really good juicy ones.
Yeah, there's a lot.
We could definitely do a part 2. But if you guys enjoy these chatty relationship Q&A videos, let us know in the comments down below. If there is a topic you want us just to dive right into, let me know. I'm going to have a poll in the top right-hand corner for you guys to vote on maybe a topic you guys want to hear more about, maybe that we just kind of touched on a little bit in this video.
Yeah, so lots of stuff.
Yeah.
Lots of stuff.
And if you guys didn't know, we vlog every single week on Friday. You can see behind the scenes, you can see more of this guy. And yeah, we share kind of our life and journey with you guys. So it's a lot of fun. Check us out there. Also subscribe to this channel down below. Click that red button. We post every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So.
I was looking for the button.
Oh, it's down there somewhere.
Somewhere down there.
Yeah.
Somewhere down there.
So thanks, man.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. Do you have lipstick on? No, I don't think I do.
No, we're good.
Thank you so much. You did good. Matt's not always the most comfortable in front of the camera. Well, like I'm on the camera in front of the camera.
I just don't do it that much anymore.
Yeah. So. You're not like shy or anything. Yeah. You just don't.
Just like, it's like anything, just getting over. It's like public speaking or something, right? You're going to like do it more and more. So
I think you did great.
So. More of this.
Hashtag more Matt.
More of this face here.
Yeah, he's so cute.
Okay.
Okay. Bye guys. We're so hungry. My stomach's growling.
It's like 4 o'clock. Haven't had lunch yet.
We gotta walk.
All I have is like a piece of banana bread.
Yeah. Sorry. Actually, I have an idea for lunch, so I'll make
health
us
nut, eh?
I'm gonna make us some open face sandwiches, and then we can go for a walk.
Okay. All right, guys. Ciao.
Bye.